From your Cape Coral news team, NBC2 is digging for answers after Cape Coral Mayor Marnie Sawicki's ex-husband and former city firefighter was arrested in Miami on domestic abuse charges. Good evening and thanks for joining us. I'm Brittany Weiner.
And I'm Trent Kelly. Miami Beach police say it all happened late last night at the Fontainebleau Hotel. Now that's the same hotel where the mayor is staying this weekend for the U.S. Conference of Mayors.
NBC2's Megan Bragg spoke with Cape Coral residents about this incident. Megan.
Yeah, that's right. According to that police report, the former lieutenant with the Cape Coral Fire Department, Kenneth Retzer, is accused of strangling a woman and punching her in the face several times. Now, this is not the first time Retzer has been in the spotlight for domestic abuse, and many I spoke to in Cape Coral say it's not a good look for the city.
This Miami Beach police report details a terrifying attack by the Cape Coral mayor's ex-husband. Police say former Cape Coral Fire Lieutenant Kenneth Retzer had been drinking with a woman at the Fontainebleau Hotel in Miami. The two went up to their room, and that's when things escalated. The report says Retzer straddled the victim on a bed and placed his hands around her throat and punched her several times.
That's just like shame on him. You know, and it's just not a good look.
The victim was able to get away by scratching and biting Retzer's finger. He then punched a wall and left the hotel room.
Cape Coral is beautiful, but this is downgrading Cape Coral when you get those kind of story.
Retzer's former wife, Cape Coral Mayor Marnie Sawicki, was staying at the hotel for a mayor's conference. When we called the room number listed on the police report, Sawicki picked up but had no comment. Although the victim is not named, the report does say the victim told police she had been in a relationship with Retzer since 2013. Last year, the mayor filed a restraining order against Retzer for harassment, and in 2016, an investigation started. Following these bizarre 911 calls Retzer made from Sawicki's home.
Look at this. That's your phone.
Some Cape Coral residents say enough is enough.
This looks bad on the city of Cape Coral, and that's falling back not only on her, but just our city in general. I don't think that's a good look.
The investigation into Retzer is still ongoing. We did reach out to council members today, but they did not want to comment on this incident at this time. Live in the control room, Megan Bragg, NBC2.